Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali M.L. Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is module number 6, Steam Power Cycle. We are going to discuss about the vapor power cycle or the steam power cycle. This is the first lecture on the module 6. So we recap from the previous lecture series on the properties of steam and the process with the steam. In the module 5, we discuss about the properties of steam, formation of steam and the process with the steam. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the Rankine cycle. We are going to derive the efficiency of the Rankine cycle and we will discuss the mean temperature of heat addition. The learning outcome for the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain Rankine cycle with the PV and TS diagram, pressure volume and temperature entropy diagram, and the student will be able to derive the efficiency of the Rankine cycle, and the student will be able to define the steam rate and the heat rate for the Rankine cycle. Before we enter into the Rankine cycle, we just recall the properties of steam, which is very important for calculating the parameters here. First, the specific volume. So we know there are three types of steam: wet steam, dry saturated steam, and the superheated steam. The specific volume of the wet steam, V wet equal to 1 minus x into Vf plus x into Vg, where Vf is the specific volume of the water and Vg is the specific volume of the steam. And the specific volume of the dry saturated steam, V dry equal to Vg, and the specific volume of the superheated steam, V super equal to Vg into T by Ts. So, T is the temperature of the superheated steam and Ts is the saturation temperature. And specific enthalpy of the steam, of wet steam. So, first you take the wet steam, H wet equal to Hf plus X into Hfg. For dry steam, H dry equal to Hg. And for superheated steam, H super equal to Hg plus Cp into T minus Ts, where T is the temperature of the superheated steam, Cp is the specific heat of the steam, and Ts is the saturation temperature. Hf is the specific enthalpy of water, and Hfg is the specific specific enthalpy of evaporation. And the specific entropy of the steam, H wet, for wet steam, S wet, entropy of wet steam equal to Sf plus X into Sfg, and entropy of dry steam equal to Sg, and entropy of superheated steam equal to Sg plus Cp into logarithmic of T by Ts. Now, all the parameter here, Vg, Hf, Hfg, saturation temperature, Hg, everything, Sf, Sfg, Sg, everything we can take from the steam table depending on the temperature or pressure. Now, to discuss the vapor power cycle or the steam power cycle, first let us look at the layout of the steam power plant. Take few seconds and look at the steam power plant, various components of the steam power plant. So, there are various components. First, we look at the boiler. So, boiler is a device where the water is converted into steam, and for the boiler the heat is given from the furnace. So in the furnace the burning of the fuel takes place, and this may be a liquid fuel or the solid fuel. So the burning of the fuel is taking place in the furnace. The hot gas are produced, the hot heat is given to the boiler, which is used to convert the water into steam. So, the high pressure, high temperature steam from the boiler enters the steam turbine. In the steam turbine, we have number of stages, multiple stages of the steam turbine, and the steam is expanded in the steam turbine. Work is produced, the work produced equal to Wt, and the steam is leaving. So, at low quality, the steam is leaving the turbine, and the steam, generally the wet steam leaving the turbine, it goes to the condenser, where it is condensed using the water from a river or any river or lake. The water is circulated through the condenser. So, the steam is converted into liquid. So, here in the condenser, the heat is rejected, the condensate is circulated. So using the pump, so the condensate is recirculated back to the boiler. So the steam power plant, a simple steam power plant. So we have a boiler where the, we are supplying heat energy to convert water into steam, and we have a turbine, so which is converting the steam enthalpy of the steam into work done, and the steam leaving the turbine goes to the condenser where it is being condensed, so converted into liquid, and the liquid, that is water, it is using the pump, it is circulated back to the boiler. So this is the steam power plant. When you go for the detailed components of the steam power plant, we have various circuits, but these are all the four basic components of the steam power plant. And this is open system. So the gas is, it is open, completely open system, because the continuously fuel is supplied to the furnace and the heat is produced and the heat is entering here. Now we take a simple vapor power cycle, the Rankine cycle or vapor power cycle, which is the basic cycle for the steam power plant. The same four components we have. We have a boiler, we have a turbine, we have a condenser, and we have a pump. Now the process 1 to 2, so 1 is the condition of the steam entering the turbine, 1 to 2 is the expansion of the turbine. So 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic expansion. So the work is produced. So this reversible adiabatic expansion work is produced, and 2 to 3 it is condensation. So during the condensation process, the pressure remains constant. So in the condensation process, the heat is rejected from the steam. So 2 to 3 is reversible constant pressure heat rejection. And 3 to 4, so the water leaving the condenser is pressurized. Using the pump, we are pressurizing the water. So 3 to 4 is reversible adiabatic compression. So the high pressure water, it is circulated back to the boiler. So 4 to 1 is the reversible constant pressure heat addition. So 4 to 1 is reversible constant pressure heat addition. So the four processes, 1 to 2 reversible adiabatic expansion, 2 to 3 reversible constant pressure heat rejection, 3 to 4 reversible adiabatic compression, and 4 to 1 reversible constant pressure heat addition. So these are all the four processes in the vapor power cycle or simple Rankine cycle. And the outlet or the efficiency of the cycle depending on the quality of the steam. So we know there are three different types of steam: wet steam, dry saturated steam, and the superheated steam. Now first you take the temperature entropy diagram. So this is the saturation line. So the saturated liquid line, critical point, and saturated vapor line. And 1 to 2 is the expansion in the turbine, isentropic expansion in the turbine. And the output of the turbine, depending on the inlet condition of the steam, we have taken all the three types. So 1 dash is the wet steam. So 1 dash to 2 dash the expansion of the wet vapor. 1 to 2 is the expansion of dry saturated vapor. And 1 double dash to 2 double dash is the expansion of superheated vapor. So the temperature entropy diagram. So 1 to 2, 1 dash to 2 dash wet vapor expansion, 1 to 2 it is dry saturated vapor, and 1 double dash to 2 double dash is the dry saturated superheated vapor. So in all the three cases, if you look at the outlet of the turbine, it is always wet steam. And normally in the turbine, we do not expand the wet vapor. Either it may be a dry saturated steam at the entry of the turbine or superheated steam. So at the entry of the turbine, it may be a superheated steam or dry saturated steam. Now 2 to 3 is the heat rejection. 2 to 3 is the heat rejection, the condenser, and 3 to 4 is the pump work. So the again isentropic compression. So the temperature increases, entropy remains constant, and 4 to 1 is the 4 to 1 is the heating process in the boiler. So first the water, unsaturated water, it is converted into saturated water, then it is converted into steam, and then it is superheated steam. So this is the entropy, temperature entropy diagram. Actually all the four processes are shown here in the enthalpy entropy diagram. So 1 to 2 is the expansion of the turbine, 2 to 3 is the condensation, 3 to 4 is the pump work, and 4 to 1 is the heat addition process. And similarly here we take the PV diagram. So again 1 to 2. So this is 1. So 1 to 2 it is the expansion, isentropic expansion. 2 to 3 it is a constant pressure heat rejection. 3 to 4 it is isentropic, 3 to 4 is constant pressure heat addition, the isentropic compression, and 4 to 1 is the constant pressure heat addition. So 1 to 2 isentropic expansion, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat rejection, 3 to 4 isentropic compression, and 4 to 1 constant pressure heat addition. So the PV, TS and the HS diagram. So in any problem, better we draw any one of the diagram. Most popular diagram is temperature entropy diagram. So we draw the temperature entropy diagram for all the numerical example when we are solving the problem. And now we calculate the work done and efficiency of the work done and the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. So the four devices, so we have four component: boiler, turbine, condenser and the pump. So how we are going to derive, how you are going to calculate the working parameter? It is just applying the steady flow energy equation. So for steady flow energy equation for the boiler, so for the boiler, the inlet condition is 1, outlet condition is 2. For the condenser, inlet condition is 2, outlet condition is 3. For the pump, inlet condition is 3, outlet condition is 4. For the boiler, inlet condition is 4, outlet condition is 1. For the boiler, heat is supplied. For the turbine, work is produced. For the condenser, heat is rejected. For the pump, work is given to the pump. So just balancing the energy in the steady flow energy equation. For the boiler, Q1 plus H4, amount of heat supplied is Q1, H4 is the enthalpy of the water, the entry of the boiler, that is equal to H1. So our amount of heat added in the boiler, Q1 equal to H1 minus H4. The steady flow energy equation for the turbine, H1 enthalpy of the steam at the inlet of the turbine, that is equal to WT, work done by the turbine, plus H2 enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the turbine. So from here WT equal to H1 minus H2. The steady flow energy equation for the condenser. So H2 is the enthalpy of the steam entering the condenser, that is equal to Q2, the amount of heat rejected, plus H3, enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the, enthalpy of the water at the outlet of the condenser. So Q2 equal to H2 minus H3. And for the pump, WP plus H3. So WP plus H3 equal to H4. So WP, work done by the pump, work input to the pump equal to H4 minus H3. Now the pump work, so the enthalpy of the, for the pump work we calculate, we derive another equation. For pump work, H equal to U plus PV. Generally H enthalpy equal to U plus PV. We differentiate dH equal to dU plus PdV plus VdP. So dH, dU plus PdV equal to del Q. So from the first law of thermodynamics, dU plus PdV equal to del Q plus VdP. For adiabatic process, del Q equal to 0, so dH equal to VdP. So from this equation, dropping del Q, dH equal to VdP, and integrating the equation between 3 and 4, inlet of the pump is 3, outlet of the pump is 4, so H4 minus H3 equal to V. So in the pump, the fluid is liquid, so the specific volume of the liquid, specific volume of the water is constant, so integrating dP, so P4 minus P3. So H4 minus H3, the pump work input equal to the specific volume of the water into P4 minus P3, or P4 equal to P1 and P3 equal to P2. So or this is also equal to V into P1 minus P2. That is what the pump work for the Rankine cycle. Now the efficiency of the Rankine cycle, eta equal to, general expression is W net, net to work output divided by the heat supplied. So in the Rankine cycle, net work output equal to turbine work minus pump work divided by the heat supplied. So turbine work, what we derived, H1 minus H2, pump work, what we derived, H4 minus H3 divided by H1 minus H4. So efficiency of the cycle equal to, you remember, WT minus WP divided by Q1, or H1 minus H2 minus of H4 minus H3 divided by H1 minus H4. And we define another parameter, steam rate. The rate of steam flow required to produce unit shaft output, that is 1 kilowatt of power. So, the steam amount of steam flow required to produce 1 kilowatt of power, that is what called as steam rate. And the steam rate equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP in kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, the amount of steam required in kilograms per hour per kilowatt, that is what the steam rate. And the heat rate is the amount of heat input required to produce unit shaft power. So, 1 kilowatt of amount of heat required to produce 1 kilowatt of power, it is what called as heat rate. And heat rate equal to 3600 into Q1 divided by WT minus WP, or this is also equal to 3600 divided by the efficiency of the cycle. So, this is in kilojoules per kilowatt hour. So, efficiency equation, steam rate equation and heat rate equation, that you have to remember, because almost in all the problems they will ask efficiency of the cycle and the steam rate. So, steam rate indicates the economy of the cycle. So, the amount of steam required in any cycle, the amount of steam required should be less. So, then only the effectiveness of the power plant will be better. And frictional losses are the heat losses in the turbine and the pump. So, we assume that the processes are reversible process, reversible adiabatic expansion in the turbine, reversible constant pressure heat addition, reversible constant pressure heat rejection, or reversible adiabatic compression. But in practice, all the processes are not reversible. So, frictional losses or heat leakage will occur in turbine and the pump. So, we have to account that. So, for turbine, so 1 to 2 is the isentropic expansion and 1 to 2 dash is the actual expansion. So, the deviation, isentropic condition to actual expansion, the deviation is due to the friction in the turbine. So, considering the friction in the turbine, we define the turbine efficiency. So, turbine efficiency equal to actual work divided by the isentropic work. So, which is equal to H1 minus H2 dash divided by H1 minus H2. So, using the steam table or the Mollier chart, we can calculate H1 and H2. So, H2 dash we have to calculate using this equation. And similarly for the pump. So, 3 to 4. So, 3 to 4 is the isentropic compression and 3 to 4 dash is the actual compression. Now, the pump efficiency is defined as isentropic work divided by the actual work. So, eta P equal to Ws divided by Wa, which is H4 minus H3 divided by H4 dash minus H3. So, sometimes they will give the turbine efficiency and the pump efficiency. Then, you have to use these expressions to calculate the enthalpy at the outlet of the turbine, or work done by the turbine and work input to the pump. And we take the next topic, mean temperature of heat addition. So, this is your Rankine cycle, 1 to 2S, 2 to 3, 3 to 4S, 4S to 5. Now, the TS diagram that indicates the area under the TS diagram, that indicates the amount of heat transfer in a cycle. Now, the total amount of heat transfer in the Rankine cycle, the area enclosed by 1, 2S, 3, 4S and 1. So, this area. Now, this is irregular in shape. We make it as a rectangle. So, we draw another line 5 to 6 such that the area of the Rankine cycle is equal to area of the rectangle. That is 5, 6, 2, 3. Area of the rectangle is equal to area of the Rankine cycle in the TS plane. Then we calculate the heat addition in the Rankine cycle. So, Q1 equal to H1 minus H4S. H1 minus H4S is equal to Tm into S1 minus S4S. So, Tm is the mean temperature of heat addition, S1 minus S4S, or the mean temperature of heat addition equal to the enthalpy change H1 minus H4S divided by S1 minus S4S. So, this is the this equation is also important to calculate the mean temperature. So, the mean temperature of heat addition should be maximum to improve the efficiency of the value Tm value should be higher to increase the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries or clarification, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. Thank you for watching and we will meet again.